Hey, it's John and Mike, brew-dudes.com, and I wanted to ask Mike more about his brewstand. He revealed the big wort chiller edition in last week's video, so tell us more about how your brewstand's doing, brah.
So the brewstand's good. I don't remember if I've posted it before, but I mean, the big thing is that I've got the third burner in place, so that's good. So the basics, the structure of the stand, the plumbing of the stand, it's all done.
Yeah.
When I embarked on making the brew stand, my biggest concern really was not so much the structural part of it, but the plumbing.
Okay.
And the plumbing meaning running gas line and stuff like that. And so the biggest concern is how do you take from one tank and go into three burners with it?
Yeah.
And I knew from doing some gas plumbing in my house that I could just use the black pipe. It's called black pipe, and it's used for running, you know, propane or natural gas. The good thing is that a friend of mine, Wade Hicks, from a long time ago, he built a brew stand too and discovered the hard way that you can't just run the pipe and then use like some sort of flexible tube and go into a burner. You have to have this thing called an orifice, and what the orifice does is it actually controls right at the point of the burner, kind of like the jet of the gas coming through. So it's coming through at a certain pressure.
Okay.
And depending on the type of fuel you're using, whether it be propane or natural gas, they both, the supply is at a different pressure, so it requires a different size orifice.
I see.
If the orifice isn't right, or if you don't have one at all, you just kind of get this candle-like burn because the pressure isn't right.
Yeah.
And you don't get a good enough mix at the with that flapper valve.
Yeah.
At the end of your burner. So it has to be kind of going through there at a certain rate to pull oxygen in and get a good mix.
So you prefer a bigger orifice?
Well, sometimes it depends. Again, it depends on the supply. The supply,
got
right?
It.
So, but the good thing is I already knew about that. So you can buy the right orifice for the fuel. I'm using propane. The good thing, too, is if I ever do go to natural gas, because there is natural gas plumbed out in my garage, I can just undo some of my plumbing. I did the plumbing, the control plumbing, right at the burner in such a way that I could easily undo that and change the orifice out and go to a natural gas orifice. So that would be cool. But the good thing is I was really surprised when I had the first two burners together and I first fired it up. It lit right up, right away. I didn't have any just yellow, poor flame. I got the blue flame right away.
Nice.
And I could really make it scream.
Yeah.
And I could also turn on two burners, and both of them could scream
right
away.
Yeah.
I did notice once I had the third burner plumbed, is that if I had two burners going and then opened the third burner, there just isn't enough pressure from the tank to do that, to have that much output going at the same time. And I don't know if that's, because I don't know much about plumbing and gas, per se. I don't know if I'd use maybe a quarter inch pipe or three versus half inch pipe.
Yeah.
I might be, just not, the system's probably not balanced.
Okay.
But the good thing is, if you envision having an HLT, a mash tun, and a boil kettle, and how brewing is done, there's really never a point where you're actually firing three burners at once. You're heating mash water. Then your main, like for me, I'm doing a direct fired mash tun, and even that's just sporadic heating. And then when you're boiling, you're probably not heating mash water anymore.
No.
So you really only need two burners. The whole point of a three station brew stand is just the convenience of it and the coolness factor. I mean, you can put like 20 burners on the thing, but you're only going to use two at any given time. So, so that part works out pretty good.
Good.
I still have my pump mounted on a box, which I think we've seen videos of before.
Yep.
Next time I do a brew session, I'll try to maybe do some highlights of in operation. I've used the stand for two brews so far, but I still don't have the MLT built yet. I just use my normal stainless steel pot, but that's been fine. Who cares? Eventually, I will build an MLT because what I want to do for my
MLT,
HLT,
an HLT.
It's an MLT. Mash louder tank.
Oh, nice.
And then hot liquor tank.
Of course,
so I'm going to build the hot liquor tank. What I'm going to do with that one, I'm going to put like a thermometer and sight glass on it with a ball valve as well. Because I figure what I would do is I'd be able to fill the HLT with water to a certain level on the sight glass. And then I'll be able to just, using my pump directly into the mash tun and just watch the sight glass go down. In the past, the way I've brewed is I just kind of heat an excess of water,
yeah,
and then transfer it into a bucket and measure it and then dump it in the in the mash tun.
Yeah, yeah.
And it kind of becomes a, that's just extra steps.
Yeah, sure.
So if I can pump directly and watch a sight glass,
save 5 minutes.
It'll make you feel cool and it'll save a few more minutes on the total
right.
session. So
good, good, good. Saving time.
Exactly. Yeah. So the only detractor to how I built the stand is, if you remember and go all the way back to the very first video, is this stand was originally an aquarium stand for a pretty large aquarium, probably like a 50-gallon aquarium. And it was pretty tall. And when I put a keg on top of it, it kind of came to about my chest. I mean, I could still look into it, but if I was going
to
stir a mash,
you
I'd be like this. And, yeah. and the good thing is, too, now that I've used it, there's a lot of heat that comes out from under it. So if it was this tall, you'd have to get kind of close to it to work, and who knows.
Burning
if you're wearing
hair.
A tie that day, and you're wearing a tie, it'd probably be bad news. What might mean a chest hair, but your gut would be, you know. So,
ties to a brew session?
Well, it depends on what you're brewing.
That's right. Yeah.
Really, you know.
Something more sophisticated.
Like a Saison. You want to dress up for a Saison.
Really? Farmhouse ale, man?
Okay, you know, maybe not.
Yeah,
so
no.
what would you...
I don't know.
Bring the tuxedo out
something.
For the... For the Belgian triple?
Yeah, something like that.
Oh, beer de garde.
Yeah, beer de garde.
Beer de garde
yeah,
requires
yeah.
a tie.
Yeah, well, I think that's more of a bow tie.
Oh, probably. Good point.
Be careful.
So anyway, so I figured the brew stand had a weird decorative leg to it and a solid leg. And I talked in the video.
Took it off, right?
I took it off. And so that's what I did, because you've seen the picture of the stand so far. So the only detractor is that the stand is a little short. I mean, it's great for looking in the kettle and adding hops and stirring and all that.
Awesome.
I wanted it higher, one, because if I ever had to go to gravity to drain something, I could.
Yeah.
Because the stand would be this high and a carboy would be this high. But now, carboys are higher than my ball valve, so I can't just drain if I had to. The other thing is that because it's so low to the ground, I originally planned on mounting the pump in the brew stand, but it's so low to the ground that there really isn't a lot of... There's plenty of room for the pump, but it's too close to the burners. And I'm afraid that the heat actually splashes off the bottom of the kettle significantly. Mm. You put your hand under there, it doesn't burn you, but it's hot. And I think that it would literally burn out the pump. So so that's okay. I still got it on a stand. And I'm going to build a little stand for the pump and the plate chiller all in one thing. And the plate chiller will be higher than a carboy, so it'll into the carboy. Yeah, just like that. It'll be music. It'll go.
Good.
So, with my tie on. So...
Your string quartet.
Exactly.
Background.
Well, you got to orchestrate your brewing.
That's
so,
true.
Anyway, the brew stand's been great. I'll probably try to shoot more of a detailed brewing session focused on the stand.
Yep.
At some point in the future, in the near future. But I'm still plugging away at trying to build, like, HLT and whatever, and so... I gotta stop building stuff and go back to brewing beer, because we just keep drinking cream ale.
I know.
So
year after year.
Anyway, so the brew stand has been exciting. It's functional. I'm enjoying it, and I would encourage other people to give it a try. Yeah.
Well, I'm glad I asked.
Great.
Because I haven't had to say too much.
You didn't say anything.
No.
Yeah.
Good. John Mike, brewdashy.com. Brew on.
Brew on.